A rumbling robot and high-flying drone recently came to Clemson University's Simpson Research Farm to burrow through and buzz over 15 acres of experimental sorghum plots containing more than 2,800 replicated varieties. The space-age devices, conceived and constructed by Carnegie Mellon University and Near Earth Autonomy in collaboration with Clemson University and other partners, are designed to significantly enhance the ease and frequency of data collection for crop testing in ways that will eventually benefit agricultural production both in South Carolina and around the world.
For the project Boost, what we're trying to do is focus on linking plant genetics, plant genomics, plant breeding with high throughput technology to establish and measure plant traits. These plant traits can be phenotypic measurements of leaves or roots or grain, and the intent is to work to develop a vertically integrated system that includes genetics, robotics, sensing, computational sciences to be able to look at broad amounts of data and be able to analyze that to identify either useful genes or useful genotypes or varieties that can be used for the production of liquid transportation fuels. At present, we work through the field walking, visualizing things, and what we'd like to do is be able to do that magnitudes quicker and magnitudes more precisely. So we hope to use the instrumentation in getting us through the field with robotics and sensing to collect the data that we need.
Because of our growing season, because of the nature of sorghum being a potentially shorter crop, able to grow on less quality land than some of our more nutrient intensive crops. So what they're doing here, and combined with potential energy markets, the poultry market, you name it, that sorghum is one of the answers, but as was pointed out, this technology will apply to all of our crops, and using the technology produce crops at a better margin of cost, on cost, is really what I wanted to learn about. I'm very impressed with it. I'm very pleased because right here in our backyards, South Carolina farmers should be the first to benefit from that because it was right next door that this is developed and it's applicable and it can work in their fields the same way it does here experimentally.
Simpson's rec duties are really to supply resources, whether that be land, labor, or equipment, and really small plot expertise. The Simpson Research Farm is about 2,400 acres, and that's comprised of agronomy, beef cattle, and the small ruminant operations here on this particular location.
So I'm a graduate student with Dr. Kresvich. I originally came up here to work with this project, specifically work with the Boost. In this field behind me, there are 400 replicated varieties, but across Clemson, we have over 5,000 different varieties, and across the state, that number is about 6,000.
We have complementary skills. We bring in the technology and the robotics. Steve Kresvich and his group bring in the expertise in the breeding and genetics, and it's difficult to find a relationship. I mean, we speak different languages, right? So it takes a lot of patience on both sides to learn how to talk, and it's a special group of people when you can make that connection. So we've definitely done that with the Clemson team. Clemson has these beautiful resources that, you know, can't be reproduced anywhere else, I don't think, and so it's a great partnership.
So I have really a variety of different functions as project manager. The first is just to make sure that the project functions smoothly, liaising with all the project teams between Clemson, Near Earth Autonomy, Carnegie Mellon University, and the Danforth Center in St. Louis, making sure that everyone's connected, that we stay attuned to each other, we liaise and make sure everything is moving smoothly and on top of everything.
I'm serving as a field manager of the Boost program. Mainly my duties include maintaining the quality of the plants while they're growing in the field, maintain their health, keeping them growing as well as we can. That includes fertilizer applications, insect herbicide applications, and then also working with the graduate students with data collection and harvesting capabilities.
So we work with sorghum, but it doesn't really matter what crop we're working with. These techniques and technologies, if successful, will be implemented across agricultural systems in the 21st century.